Hi there, Mike Kalinowski with the Infor Äôs product management team, and we're going to be downloading and configuring the Compass JDBC driver so that we can use local development tools and environments to query the Infor Data Lake. Before we begin, be sure to subscribe to the Infor Äôs YouTube channel for more information about the Infor Data Fabric, as well as other product and feature areas that you'll find within the Infor Äôs technology platform. Now, once we've actually loaded information or data into our object storage repository within the Infor Data Lake, we're able to use the Compass query platform available to us to log SQL queries against the information that we have in storage. We can access these SQL interfaces either through RESTful API services, the Compass query editor that you'll find within the browser, or in this particular case, we'll be using conventional database drivers to equip a local data environment so that we can begin to query the Infor Data Lake with local tools. Now, this could also be ETL tooling, as well as third-party reporting, analytics scenarios, and so on, but there's a lot of capabilities here that you can use the JDBC driver in particular for. Before we get started, make sure that you've downloaded and installed Amazon Coreto and set up a local database manager application. In this particular case, I'll be using DBeaver. And then we're going to walk through how to set up the Compass JDBC driver, as well as configuring our authorized application and acquiring our security credentials file, which our local client is going to use to authenticate against the Infor cloud. Before we get started, be sure to take a look at docs.infor.com and more specifically the development guide for Infor Äôs, where you'll find more information about the Infor Data Lake, as well as how to query it and additional information about the Compass JDBC driver that we have available here. So let's go ahead and take a look at Infor Äôs here. We'll begin by navigating over to Äôs Desk, and just as an example here, as we've seen in previous videos, we're able to use the Compass Query Editor to very quickly prototype and pilot queries against the Infor Data Lake, just to see if there are going to be any sort of syntactical or grammatical issues or any sort of problems that we anticipate with the types of queries that we're going to run against the Infor Data Lake. But this only takes us halfway. How do we get this information out of the environment and then equip with third-party utilities or ecosystems? Well, in this particular case, we're going to set up that JDBC driver, and we'll start by going over to the configuration area and download section of Äôs Desk. Here we can download a local copy of our JDBC driver, which is always up to date within the Infor Äôs tenant. And before we play around with that file just yet, we're going to proceed to set up our authorized application within the gateway here. So we'll navigate over to Infor Äôs API, authorized apps, and we're going to go ahead and create a new authorized application here. We'll call this Infor Compass JDBC driver and select the backend service option over here. We can give this the same exact name for the description that we've selected above. And once we've got that configured, we can simply save our new entry over here. Now we have the option to download credentials, which is going to be our Äôs API file that's used for authentication against the Infor cloud here. So make sure that you select the create service account option and then enter in your IFS username that you have available to you. And this is going to be the account that the service account is impersonating when connecting to the Infor cloud. So let's go ahead and click download. And now that we have both of the files that we need to get started here, we'll navigate over to our file directory on our local machine here. So I have two files, our Äôs API file, as well as our JDBC zip file. We'll go ahead and unpack that zip and drill into the folder. There are a few files here, but the one that we're interested in is our jar file. Just simply drag and drop this into a local folder on your machine that you've set up. If you're using Windows, I recommend using something like C Infor Data Lake. On Mac, something similar within your libraries folder as well. We also want to copy over our API file that we generated within the authorized application section of the video. And this is going to be used during our authentication step when we connect to the Infor Data Lake. So now that we've got everything configured in our local environment on the file side, let's go ahead and start connecting over to the Data Lake itself. So I've already got DBeaver open here in the background, and we're going to go and set up a new driver interface within the driver manager here. So we'll select that new option, and we'll extend this out so we can see what we're working with here. And we're going to enter in Infor Data Lake as our logical name. We'll keep the driver type generic, and for our class name, we're going to enter in com.infor.idl.jdbc.driver with a capital D. You can find this information within the setup and installation guides both on the support portal as well as docs.infor.com. For our URL template, we're going to enter in JDBC colon Infor Data Lake colon slash slash and then our tenant name. Now we need to add in our jar file, which is going to be how we connect to the Infor Data Lake here. So we'll select that jar, and then we also need to add in a folder so that it can detect our Äôs API file used for authentication here. So I'm going to keep the default selection here and simply hit OK, and then we can hit OK on our configuration setup within the driver manager. We'll hit close, and then on the left navigation panel here, we'll go ahead and right click and create a new connection. Now we can filter very quickly for our new driver entry that we created within the manager itself and select next. We can keep the username and password blank because we're using the authorized application credentialing file as our means of authentication here. So simply we'll just go ahead and click on finished, and we see that we have a new connection in our navigator panel. So we'll expand this, and we can connect to the data lake directly from a local development environment. In this case, all of our information and tables that we can access through the Compass query language is available within the default schema that we have here, and we can expand that tables tree to find more information that you'll find otherwise listed within the Infor data catalog here. Now, if we come back over to our Infor Äôs environment, we'll go ahead and grab that same query that we ran within Compass, and we can grab that to very quickly validate our connection against the Infor Data Lake using the JDBC driver. So we'll go ahead and grab this query here, and then we'll jump back over to the DBeaver environment, and then we can begin launching queries directly against the Infor Data Lake itself. And there we go. That's how you can actually set up the Compass JDBC driver using local development tools, and then begin thinking about how you can embed the JDBC client within ETL tooling, third-party applications, or your own homegrown applications as well. Now, for more information and tutorials, or connecting with other members of the community, be sure to join community.infor.com, as well as subscribing to the Infor Äôs YouTube channel for more videos like this to help you get started and digging deeper into how to get the most out of the Infor Data Lake as well.